name is Jim Hines. I write fantasy novels. I live in the United States in Michigan. I've been writing since about 1995. Live with my wife and two children, three cats, two dogs, a guinea pig, and some fish. The most recent series out in France is the Magic Ex Libris books, which are about a librarian named Isaac Vaigno, who his magic is that he can reach into books and pull out anything that fits through the pages. So magic rings, magic swords, lasers from science fiction, pretty much anything you can that will physically fit through the book. He has a companion named, in French, he's Titoche, who is the fire spider, and yeah, obviously who runs around lighting things on fire. The books are set present day. They're actually set in the upper part of Michigan where I live. And Isaac runs around fighting bad guys and doing magic and having a lot of fun. He is very much, he's very much a geek. You know, he loves magic, he loves science fiction and fantasy, so there are a lot of references to other modern science fiction fantasy works. In the three books that are out, in the first one, we meet Isaac, we learn about Libriomancy, we learn about the history of magic. In the second book, we learn that there were secrets and lies and other people doing magic, and we get lots of fighting. And at the end of that book, Isaac temporarily loses his magic. So in book three, this is where Isaac is at. He's lost his magic. He is very depressed, clinically depressed. This was actually modeled somewhat on my own dealing with depression, because I had gotten diagnosed and started taking medication at about the same time. So Isaac's struggles with everything that he's lost and his determination to get that magic back. And in the meantime, we're starting to see more and more that there is a bigger bad guy lurking under the surface. So not only is Isaac trying to get that magic back, he's also trying to fight the big bad guy without magic, which is a challenge. This is who he is. This is what he's used to. And we see more of some of the other characters in book three. Johann Gutenberg, Ponce de Leon, both are... Gutenberg is another Libriomancer. He does book magic. Ponce de Leon is a more traditional sorcerer. And it's in many ways, it feels like the climax of the series. There is a fourth book, but the third book is where we really learn the truth about this big bad and where the villain came from and who they are. And we figure out, okay, now what are we going to do about it? I don't think I'm trying to defend science fiction fantasy. And it's not even necessarily a call to people that, hey, we should all read this. More than anything, I think I wanted to celebrate for those of us who already love this stuff, to say these books are wonderful and amazing, and I love this genre, you know, science fiction and fantasy. I have been reading all my life. I love the books. I love that the stories will ask, what if we did this? You know, they look to the future of what could we do, what could we accomplish. And on the fantasy side, they create such a sense of wonder and imagination, and it's inspiring. And if, you know, if my books inspire people to go out and read more, that's wonderful. That wasn't really my main goal, though. It was more just to celebrate and to write a book, or write four books at this point, saying science fiction and fantasy are wonderful, we love it, all of you people who are part of that community, I love you all. You are wonderful people. We are awesome. We are magic. Go us, basically. And I mean, I do hope it inspires people to go check out other books. That would be wonderful. There are so many good authors, so many wonderful stories out there that deserve more attention. But mostly it's just, yes, I love this stuff. Let's all celebrate.